Good morning students. So in this class we are going to discuss about how microwave oven works. So we can find the wavelength of that microwave oven produce. So it's from the high vacuum tubes, that is magnetron, klystron and GaN diode. So the microwaves are produced inside the microwave oven. So microwave oven, so inside the microwave oven, so standing waves are produced. So standing waves means, so like that. So this is a node, this is a antinode. So this is a node, antinode. So at the points of antinode it is maximum. So at the points of antinode is maximum, at the points of node is zero. So if we place a chapati inside, so if we place a chapati inside the microwave oven, so the amplitude of is maximum at the antinodes. So the wavelength produced by the microwave oven is lambda is equal to 1 millimeter to 30 centimeter. So we can observe the chapati after cooking. So there is a two spots. So these two spots, the distance between, that is lambda by 2. That is here the distance between the two antinodes, because at antinodes its amplitude is maximum. So at that point the food is cooked very well. So that two spots gives the half of the wavelength. So the distance between the antinode and consecutive two antinodes gives the half of the wavelength. So we can find the wavelength. So that mu is equal to c by lambda. So we can find the velocity of light using microwave oven. So we know that frequency of that microwave oven produced, that is mentioned in the panel of microwave oven. So if we substitute, we will get c is equal to mu times lambda. So find the lambda using a scale. You can measure the length between the two spots, that is the distance between the two antinodes. So and also we can find the frequency. So what is the frequency of that microwave oven it produces? So we can find that mu is equal to c by lambda. So we know microwave is an electromagnetic wave, so it should produce the speed, that is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second that wave travels, and the wavelength, that is from 1 millimeter to 30 millimeter. So from this microwave oven, so we can find the frequency of the microwave and also what is the wavelength it produces. So and also there is a problem is given, that is magnetron produces a frequency 2450 megahertz. So is it possible? So what is the magnetic field strength is to rotate the electron in the circular path. So what is the formula just I mentioned? So this is the frequency. So the angular frequency omega equal to 2 pi f. If you substitute the values, you will get the angular frequency. So angular frequency in terms of hertz, so frequency equal to 1 by t. So frequency in terms of hertz, so 1 by t is second power minus 1. So in this step they are using second power minus 1, just it is in hertz. The next step it's second power minus 1. Then what is the magnetic field? So B is equal to m omega by q, the magnitude of that charge. So here the electron, so in this, that is magnetron produces a electromagnetic wave in the microwave oven. So what is the magnetic field, the required magnetic field to rotate the electron in the circular path? This is a question. So just I say the formula, what is the formula, then how to use. So the magnetic field B is equal to m omega by q, that is magnitude of charge. So the mass of the electron, we know 9.11 into 10 power minus 19 kg, it's in kilogram. Then charge of electron, so minus 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. So here it should be minus 31 kg. So just see, charge of electron 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, mass of electron 9.11 into 10 power minus 31 kg. So they are asking magnitude. So the magnitude means just plus 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. If you substitute the values, the mass of the electron, then angular frequency that is in 10 power 10, then charge. So finally you will get 0.08763 tesla. So this value, this magnitude value, we can produce using a permanent magnet. So permanent magnet, so this magnetic field is produced using a permanent magnet. So that magnetic field is enough to cook the food because it absorbs the water molecules present in the food. So if you are cooking, means the food should be have some water molecules. Then only inside that water, so there is a H2O molecule. So the breaking, it produces a heat. So the bond between hydrogen and oxygen breaks, it produces heat. So that heat is used to, that is varying electric field here for cooked food. So in this class we discuss how microwave oven works. So the microwave oven produces a microwave, that is a standing wave. So standing wave means there is a node and antinode. So at the nodes, these points, the value is zero. If it is at antinode, the value is maximum. So maximum amplitude, so at that point it's cooked well or burned well. So we are measuring the distance between that burned well, the two points, gives the wavelength of the, that is half of the wavelength of microwaves. So from this we can find the frequency, or the frequency is mentioned in the parallel. We can find the velocity of light. It's an electromagnetic wave, so all electromagnetic waves are moves in a velocity 3×10^8 meter per second. That's a standard one. Then we have seen one problem. So consider a klystron. So the magnetron produces a frequency 2450 megahertz. So is this enough for to rotate the electron in the circular path? What is the required magnetic field, they are asking. So what's the formula? Omega equal to 2 pi f, then magnetic field B equal to m omega by q. So we get answer 0.08763 tesla. So this magnetic field is produced even with a permanent magnet. So this magnetic field is enough to cook a food because it is absorbed by the water molecules. So okay students,